My dear learners, for this course on turbo machines, in this final module, that is in module 5, we were discussing about centrifugal pumps and centrifugal compressors. In our previous lecture, I have introduced you people to the theoretical concepts of centrifugal pumps. Continuing our discussion on centrifugal pumps, in today's lecture, we are ready to conduct analysis of centrifugal pumps. Before solving the problems on centrifugal pumps, first we should discuss the prerequisites. The prerequisites in turbo machines are velocity triangles and the formulas required to conduct performance analysis. First, let us recall the velocity triangles for centrifugal pumps. The velocity triangle for centrifugal pumps is already discussed in our module 2, wherein which we have conducted the general analysis of turbo machines. During the derivation of theoretical head capacity relationship for centrifugal pump and compressor, I have clearly explained the three different velocity triangles for backward curved vane, radial vane and for forward curved vane centrifugal pump. Recalling the basics of velocity triangles of centrifugal pump, let me draw the velocity triangle which is must to solve problems on centrifugal pump. So discussing the prerequisites, so in today's lecture we are conducting analysis of centrifugal pumps. First, if I recall the prerequisites under which we should know velocity triangles. The first case is backward curved vane, for which the discharge blade angle beta 2 will be less than 90 degrees. And next, we should know velocity triangle for radial vanes, for which beta 2 is equal to 90 degrees. And next, we should know forward curved vane, for which beta 2 is greater than 90 degrees. So for all these three, the inlet velocity triangle remains the same. This you people already know. Common inlet velocity triangle, that is water enters radially, for which the inlet nozzle angle, that is inlet diffuser angle, is always 90 degrees. So here we have Vf, which is equal to V1 always for centrifugal pumps, and this is equal to Vr1, angle made by Vr1 is beta 1, and V1 is the reference, absolute to relative is blade speed, that is U1. Since alpha 1 is 90 degrees, always Vu1 is 0 for centrifugal pumps. This you people already know during our general analysis of turbo machines, which we have discussed in our module 2 itself. Now, coming for different types of vanes, the exit velocity triangle differs for this. So first, if I consider backward curved vane, so that we give you the clear intuition how we are drawing the velocity triangles at exit. So let us consider the impeller, backward curved. So this is the direction of blade rotation. The blade is curved backward. So thereby, from the exit of the blade, I will get relative velocity Vr2. And if I project a vertical line, I will get flow velocity Vf2. And here, I will get alpha 2, which is nothing but V2, discharge velocity. So this is discharge blade angle beta 2, which is less than 90 degrees. Now if I consider the reference, we have absolute to flow is Vu2, absolute to relative is U2. Now if I come for radial vane, so then we will be having beta 2 as 90 degrees like this. So this is the rotation of vane. So thereby, so this is the velocity triangle I will get for radial vanes at exit. Vf2 is equal to Vr2. So here we have beta 2 is equal to 90 degrees. here it could be alpha 2, this is V2. So from here to here, we get U2, which is equal to V2. Now coming for forward curved wings, if I draw, you will be having the wings are curved in the direction of rotation of the wings like this. So for this, we get velocity triangle like this. This is coming from the blade, so therefore this is V R2 relative velocity. If I drop a perpendicular, I will get the flow velocity V F2, and here we have V2. So now if I join the base, so from the blade we have VR2, so therefore this is blade angle greater than 90 degrees beta 2. So here this angle will be 180 degree minus beta 2. And here we have alpha 2. Absolute is the reference, absolute relative is U2. And absolute flow velocity is tangential component, that is VU2. So therefore we have blade angle like this. Here also we have blade angle like this. This flow velocity should be vertical line, 90 degree lines. Always the flow velocity is perpendicular or vertical line to the tangential component. So draw a 90 degree line. Since I am drawing a freehand sketch, it might look like inclined, but always it should be a 90 degree line to the tangential component. Flow velocity. So here also it should be 90 degree line. Keep that in mind. And here also it should be 90 degree line. Flow velocity. Here also it is 90 degree line. So this is the velocity triangles for backward curved wing, radial wing and forward curved wings, whereas inlet velocity triangle is constant. And also the synonyms to be known are, whenever we speak with impeller, impeller stands for blade, or you can also call it as rotor, whereas when you speak it as diffuser, which is nothing but stator, or it is tips to blade, or it is somewhat similar to nozzle. So impeller angles are beta 1 and beta 2. Whereas diffuser angles are alpha 1 and alpha 2, where 1 and 2 are inlet and exit for the blade. Keep that in mind, inlet and exit for the blade. So this is the velocity triangles. And next, moving for the important formulas which are required to solve problems. Next, coming for formulas. First one, if you know diameter and RPM, you can find the blade speed, that is pi dn by 60. Next, we have formula for discharge is equal to pi V1 V1 VF1, which is equal to pi V2 V2 VF2, whereas D1 and D2 are nothing but impeller diameters at inlet and exit. Blade diameter B1 and B2 are width of the blade. We are using the circumferential area because the water moves on the surface of the blade. It will not go inside the blade, it will move on the surface of the blade. Therefore I should use surface area. Surface area is circumference into thickness. So pi dB VF. Next, if you know the pipe diameter, suction pipe diameter, then discharge is also equal to pi ds square by 4 into flow velocity at inlet, where ds is suction pipe diameter. So here the careful observation is water flow inside the pipe, therefore I should take cross sectional area. Now coming for the fourth one, we already written the discharge. Next is manometric efficiency. Manometric efficiency is given by GHM, G into manometric tape divided by work done per kg, that is VU to U2, work done per kg. Work done per kg is VU to U2 by GC. So this is nothing but change in enthalpy, delta H. Unit will be joules per kg. Next, rise in temperature can be determined as, you know that delta H is equal to Cp delta T. So therefore delta T will be equal to delta H by Cp. Next, coming for rise in pressure, that is P2 minus P1, which is equal to density into delta H. Next, moving for eighth one, that is hydraulic power or power imparted to water to lift the water will be mass flow rate into work done per kg. Now we know the formula for mass flow rate. So mass flow rate is density into discharge. Work done per kg is already known. That is VU to U2 by GC. Substituting the value of GC as 1. So this is what I will get in watts. Next, moving for 9th one, mechanical efficiency. Impeller power by shaft power So to avoid confusion, let me write this as impeller power itself. It is power developed by the vanes or blades of the centrifugal pump. This is impeller power. By shaft power will be given, I can find the mechanical efficiency. And coming for 10th one, if I have overall efficiency, overall efficiency is equal to manometric efficiency into mechanical efficiency into volumetric efficiency. Whereas volumetric efficiency is already known, volumetric efficiency is actual discharge by theoretical discharge. So now volumetric efficiency, by using which you can calculate overall efficiency. And finally, and very important note is that if manometric efficiency is not given, if eta mano is not given, and also not asked to calculate, then assume eta mano as 100%. A very important note is that if manometric efficiency is not given and also not asked to calculate the problem, then assume manometric efficiency as 100%. So you should assume the manometric efficiency as 100% if manometric efficiency is not given in the problem and also not asked to calculate. Then you should assume manometric efficiency as 100%, which means that we are neglecting the losses, head losses. So with this prerequisite, I think we can solve any given problem on centrifugal pumps. If there are any equations or formulas that I have missed, I add it up while we solve the problem. So with this brief revision on velocity triangles and the formulas of centrifugal pump, let us solve the problem before moving, which I have also not missed the expression for minimum starting speed, which we have derived in our previous lecture. The expression for minimum starting speed is that u2 square minus u1 square divided by 2g should be greater than or equal to hm, using which I should find the value of n. When we approach the problem, I will recall this same formula and I will demonstrate how to determine the minimum starting speed. The formula for minimum starting speed is that u2 square minus u1 square divided by 2g should be greater than or equal to hm. So for minimum, it should be equal to hm, using which I should calculate n minimum. So let us do that when we encounter problem which requires minimum starting speed. So let us solve our problem number 1. I am solving the problems, or I am giving the solutions for the problems which are attached through the question bank through the link given below the video in the description. Kindly look at the description. There I have provided a link. If you click that link, it will guide you to the question bank. For that question bank, I will be discussing the solution in this lecture series. Coming for problem number 1. The problem number 1 states that the outer dia of centrifugal pump is 50 cm and inner dia is 25 cm and runs at 1000 rpm against a head of 40 meters. Velocity of flow is constant and equal to 2.5 meters per second. Vanes are set back at an angle of 40 degrees at the outlet. Width at the outlet is 5 cm. Find vane angle at inlet, work done by impeller and manometric efficiency. So coming for problems, the first problem states that the data are for problem number 1. The data given are the outer dia of centrifugal pump d2 diameter of the vane is 50 cm, so therefore I should write it as 0.5 meters and inner diameter d1 is specified as 25, so I should write it as 0.25 meters and runs at 1000 rpm. Speed is given, which is 1000 rpm against a head of 40 meters, so always we will be specifying the manometric head. So against a manometric head of 40 meters, so whenever he says the total head, it is manometric head. Velocity of flow is constant and it is equal to 2.5 meters per second. So he is stating that flow velocity is constant. Vf1 is equal to Vf2, which is equal to Vf, which is 2.5 meters per second. Vanes are set back at an angle of 40 degrees at outlet. So vane angle, that is blade angle at exit beta2, is equal to 40 degrees. So therefore, this is a problem on backward curved vane. If the blade angle is not specified and if we ask to calculate the blade angle, always start the problem by assuming it has backward curved vane default. So this is a default. If there is an ambiguity, to choose the vanes. So once you solve, if it is radial or forward curved vane, automatically you will get the value of beta2 greater than 90 or equal to 90. But to start with, you always choose backward curved vane default whenever he asks to calculate the discharge blade angle. Since here he has given the discharge blade angle as 40 degrees, which is less than 90, I should choose backward curved vane. Clear this clear. And further data given are width at outlet is 5 cm, that is blade width B2 outlet is 5 cm, that is 0.05 meters. Find vane angle at inlet, blade angle at inlet is beta1, work done by impeller, work done per kg and manometric efficiency. Let us solve this problem. So coming for the solution of this problem, so I should use backward curved vane velocity triangle. So coming for velocity triangle, I should use velocity triangle of backward curved vanes. This This is because of the reasons he has given the value of beta 2 as 40 degree, which is less than 90. Now, start solving the problem. He has given the value of n, d1, d2. Find the value of u1 and u2. So, gate speed at inlet and exit will be u1 is equal to pi into d1 is 0.25 into n is 1000 divided by 60. So, therefore, u1 will be 13.09 meters per second. Coming for u2, pi into d2 is 0.5 to n is 1000 divided by 60, which is turning out to be 26.18 meters per second. So we have calculated u1 and u2. He has given the value of flow velocity. So from inlet velocity triangle, you know u1, you know flow velocity. I can find the value of beta 1 and vr1. So therefore, from inlet velocity triangle, if I take tan beta 1, I'll get the value of beta 1, which is equal to vf by u1. So this is vf 1. So therefore, we get the value of beta 1 as tan inverse of flow velocity is 2.5 divided by u1 is 13.09. So beta 1 is turning out to be 10.81 degrees. So we have calculated one quantity what he has asked, that is vane angle at inlet. Beta 1 is done. Next, to calculate the value of work done per kg, I require the value of Vu. Now, from the velocity triangles, careful observation is Vu2 is U2 minus X. Always we will be knowing the value of flow velocity and blade discharge angle at exit. So therefore, X can be written as Vf cot beta 2, because cot beta 2 is equal to X by Vf. So therefore, X is equal to Vf cot beta 2. So hence, here you will get Vu2 as Vu2 is equal to U2 minus X. X is Vf2 cot beta 2. So which we will be using frequently. Here Vu2 is equal to U2, no problem. Coming over here, Vu2 is U2 plus X. X can be written as Vf cot of 180 degree minus beta 2. So here I can write Vu2 as U2 plus X. X is equal to Vf2 cot of 180 degree minus beta 2. So this relation we will be using frequently. Let us solve now. I want the value of Vu2 for backward curved vane. We know that Vu2 is U2 minus X, where X is Vf2 cot beta 2. So hence, from outlet velocity triangle of backward curved vane, we have Vu2 is equal to U2 minus Vf2 cot beta 2. So therefore, Vu2 will be, U2 is known, 26.18 minus Vf2 is given 2.5, to cot of beta 2 is also given as 40 degrees. Therefore, Vu2 will be 26.18 minus 2.5 into cot beta 2. So we get Vu2 as 23.2 meters per second. So therefore, I can calculate the work done per kg. So work done per kg will be Vu2 U2 by GC. Vu2 is known, 23.2. U2 is also known, 26.18. By GC is 1. So therefore, work done per kg will be 607.39 joules per kg. So this is all done by impeller. Now next he has asked to calculate the manometric efficiency. Manometric efficiency formula is GHM by VU to U2. G is 9.81 into head is 40 meters divided by VU to U2. We have VU2 as 23.2 into U2 is 26.18. So therefore, manometric efficiency will be 64.6%. So this is the solution for problem number 1. The problems and theory concepts of centrifugal pumps are very easier compared to other modules because we are constraining the velocity triangle of centrifugal pump, for which the inlet velocity triangle is always a right angle triangle with alpha 1 is equal to 90 degrees. Hence, the problems are very easier compared to other modules. It completes the prerequisites and solutions.